So what would you do with $1 million? I'd set up two routers at the same time. Well, luckily, you don't need $1 million to set up two routers at the same time. I'm Mike, and this is the Ultimate Tech Hub. On today's episode, we're going to show you how to set up two wireless routers on the same network. When it comes to home networking, adding two wireless routers to a single network can be a difficult task. So today, I'm going to show you the quickest and easiest way to set this up. So first thing is, you'll need two wireless routers. And of these two wireless routers, whichever one is the newest and the best, we'll make that the primary router. And the second router will be the secondary router. So I'm going to call the primary router, router 1, and the secondary router, router 2. So first thing is make sure both of these wireless routers are near your computer. You'll need to access these routers via the computer. Now with router 1, this is probably the easiest setup, because the only change you'll need to make is within the wireless setting. Simply change the wireless router setting to use any channel between 1 and 6. And also take note of the IP address for this router. And typically the IP address is 192.168.1.1. Now I'm going to go on the assumption that your primary router is already set up and functions properly. So next, go ahead and plug in router 2 into your computer via the Ethernet cable. Connect and log in. Next, go to your settings and change the IP address on the secondary router to match the first one. But the third digit, you want to increase that number by 1. So if router 1 has an IP address of 192.168.1.1, you'll want router 2's IP address to be 192.168.2.1. And once the IP address is set, make sure the subnet mask matches both routers. And also set the internet gateway of router 2 to router 1's IP address. And if router 2 has UPnP, you want to make sure that's disabled. Next, on the wireless settings for router 2, make sure to set up your wireless security to be identical in router 2 as it is in router 1. Like the SSID should be the same, the password should be the same, and the wireless security settings should be exactly the same. I use WAP2. You'll want to set the wireless network to use channel 11. This will prevent IP conflicts on the network. And one more thing, in the last setting on router 2, is disable the DHCP server. Now log out of router 2 and unplug it from your computer. Now plug router 2 into router 1 via a LAN connection. So plug one cable into the LAN on router 2 and one cable into the LAN on router 1. And that's it, you're done. And it didn't cost you $1 million. Well guys, I want to thank you for watching. And if you like these videos, give a thumbs up and share it. If you love them, hit subscribe to keep this channel alive.